last question, then we're going to have Jonathan Swan. Have you talked to Robert Mueller or his team? And did you know about the Trump Tower meeting in June 2016 before it happened? Or did you see any of those visitors?
No, and no.
Jonathan Swan? The great Jonathan Swan is going to pick up on anything that I've missed or botched here. Go ahead, Jonathan.
And by see any of those visitors, I assume I've seen my husband and I've seen I've seen my brother, and but no.
But you didn't talk to any of the Russian visitors when they were
there? No.
Hi, Ivanka. As you know, workforce development doesn't happen in a vacuum. So I wanted to ask you, what do you say to workers whose livelihoods are threatened by the trade war, the tariffs, particularly workers who actually feel that they've adapted to the 21st century economy? They're working in businesses that rely on imports and exports and feel that they're being punished for, frankly, developing their businesses in the way that you might, you know, advocate in this initiative.
So I think it's a very good question, and I'll share a story with you. Last week, I was with the president, and we went to Iowa, and we did a roundtable on the subject of workforce development. Iowa has an incredibly low unemployment rate, and this is an urgent priority for them, as they're even reaching into their high schools to start to train workers earlier to serve the needs of their businesses and to ensure people are adequately trained for the growth that they want to have. Following that visit, we flew to Granite City, Illinois, and we went to a steel mill owned by U.S. Steel, and it was the celebration of an opening of that steel mill that had happened in June. And there were over 900 workers who were present, and they were sharing their stories. And these were steel workers who had been laid off roughly a year earlier and who had been told that there was no place and there was no opportunity for steel working in this country anymore. And this was a town where there were three, four generations who had worked in the steel mill. And some of them came up and they spoke, as the president spoke, and they shared their stories. And they said that their father or their mother had worked in the steel mill. Their grandmother had worked in the steel mill. And then it closed so abruptly. And for them to be back in a job, back with hope, talking about the national security element of steel, of being able to make, keep our military strong, of, God forbid, there's a war, and we need to be able to produce our steel, to be able to support ourselves and build our ships and build our equipment. But these are tough, strong, amazing people. And to see them so emotional and so grateful for the opportunity to work because of the tariffs we're talking about, because steel had been dumped in this country for so long at their expense. And one of the great companies in the world, I mean, U.S. Steel is like, you know, central casting American company. It's a legacy brand. It's like what Coca-Cola is in terms of its sort of historical significance and brand value. To see them talk about what it means to have their job back and to be back to work is the counter to what you say. Talking about the farmers, you know, the Sonny Perdue, who's amazing, is doing a great job, and he's out there every single day with our farmers. And they've seen their business. They know what's been happening. And yes, there's some certainty to the decline that they've been experiencing. It's sort of been going like this. But they've been seeing the trend. And the trend is not good, but it's predictable. And there's some comfort in predictability. But they're patriots. And they know that there's some temporary pain, but that the president's fighting for them. and that he's going to fix it, and that long term they're going to thrive. And I think you see that. I think you see that with what happened with the EU announcement last week. I think you're going to see that in the coming weeks with NAFTA and other trade deals. So at some point, you do have to right the ship. And we're not looking to create an uneven playing field for other countries. We're looking for fair and reciprocal trade deals.